Hello, in this video we are going to discuss Fibonacci basics. Just the basics. We just need to understand how to use the Fibonacci. The reason why I say just the basics only because once you have, how can I say it, mastered it, or once you just have it in you, you will be able to see the levels without having to put the Fibonacci too. All right, it's very simple. So your Fibonacci, you will find it right here on your trading view, right? Basically, let me show you. Your Fibonacci 2 would be right here. That's where you'll find your Fibonacci 2, right? On your trading view. Alright, so basically, when you're using a Fibonacci in an uptrend, you always start from the beginning, the low, right? The low of your uptrend to where price is at right now. So let's say we're working with this high that price is giving us at the moment. That's how you draw your Fibonacci too. So where your impulse started to the high, that is that price is given you. All right, if price is in a downtrend, then you have to start from the high to the low. So let's say we're using this downtrend, like this one right here, right? You want to place your Fibonacci to there. You start from the high, right? The week, the high of the week to the low of the week, because that's the whole move, to the low of the week. And there you have it. That's how you put your Fibonacci to, right? So let's say price was in this area right here. It has given you this high. And then our price is actually at this low right here. This is where price is playing it, right? So when you put your Fibonacci tree like this, you're expecting price to hit 50%, right? Maybe 61 and maybe 78. So these are the areas that you want price to hit, right? Normally, price will hit 50% and reject. Sometimes 61 and reject. But the best one would be the 78%. So the 78 and the 50% are the best ones. Yes, I know a lot of people will tell you that the 61% is the key area. But from past experience, I have noticed price will retrace 50% or 78%. And then reject. And 78% is normally where the order block is. That's where price like to hit. So let's use where price is at right now. We have price at this area right here, right? Let's say we're expecting price to reject. Remember, we're just explaining right here. If you want to see the analysis for this, you have to go watch the analysis video. But let's say price is giving us this move, right? We're saying price needs to reject where it is right now. We plot our Fibonacci from the low to the high that price has created. So if this is our low and our high that price has created, we know that price needs to retrace. Right, we know that price needs to retrace for it to give us the next move. We know that price needs to create to give us the correction wave for the next move. So where are we expecting it to hit? 50% to 78%. All right, so if you're expecting a rejection right here, this would be your target areas. Your first target area will be 50%. You can even make your first target area around 38%. Right, but these are the areas that you expect. This is the area that you're expecting price to reject. All right, so now let's say we are in the future and our analysis was telling us that price could reject this area. Right, if we say price could reject this area, here's what's crazy. Here's the beauty part of it. 50% is right here, right? So if price is going to reject this area right here and then drop to 50%, what is it retesting? Our weekly breakout. So yeah, price could drop all the way down here, give us a long week and come back and close above this area. All right. And if you look to our left, we have clean traffic. So yes, price could come all the way to this area to give us the correction wave for it to move on to the next target. All right. Another confirmation to that analysis. If you look at this area, right, let's remove the Fibonacci. Another confirmation. Look to your left, clean traffic, right? On that clean traffic, last bearish candle, right? This is our last bearish candle. That means this is our order block before the huge move, the last bearish candle before the huge move. So if that's our order block, then yes, we are being given more confirmation that price is a higher chance of coming all the way down here for it to go higher, right? What are our confirmations? The breakout, the Fibonacci, the order block, Elliott waves analysis. What more would you want? Anyways, that's it. That's the basics. You always place your two. If price was in an uptrend, you always place your two from the lowest, from the low to the high, right? Because you're expecting price to retrace going down. If price was giving you a downtrend, you start from the high to the low because you're expecting price to move up. All right, so that's basically the basics of Fibonacci. It's nothing complicated. It's just there to show you the key prices to expect price to go to, or just to give you more confirmation on your analysis, because you start seeing this in your head without having to use the tool. If you use it long enough, it will just be engraved in your head. That's it on Fibonacci tools, on Fibonacci basics, actually.